All right. My name is Nick Matzke. I'm a postdoc at the National Institute for Mathematical and Biological Synthesis at the University of Tennessee, Knoxville. I am a graduate from Berkeley. I got a PhD in integrative biology, and I work on historical biogeography and linking phylogenetics to biogeography. So when you have the evolutionary tree connecting living species, which you learned from DNA, I would like to know the history of where these species came from. How do you estimate where they lived in the past, and how do you estimate the different processes that moved them around? So was it long distance dispersal? Was it ancestors being widespread and being broken up by the continental plates splitting apart? Those sorts of questions. My other big interest is adding fossils to these analyses, which is not always easy, and linking phylogenetic analyses to species distribution models. So the reason this stuff is important is that if we can understand how species came to be in the places where they're at, this will help inform us about where species will go as climate changes. It will help inform us about how long species are likely to persist as we mess up their environments and ecosystems, and what it would take to help preserve them. So those are some of the main points about why it's important. Also, I think the most important reason that I'm interested in this is really, it's just a really interesting question. How did species get to be where they are? This is a question that goes all the way back to Charles Darwin and the origins of evolutionary biology. And it's a question that in a lot of ways is still unanswered. So there's a real scientific curiosity about that. So one of the main things I've learned in my research is really the importance of what we call founder event speciation. So evolutionary biologists for a long time have speculated about what are the most important processes that split species apart and create new species. And one of the processes that people have talked about is founder event speciation, where a rare dispersal event leads one or a few individuals to cross a major barrier, like cross an ocean. For example, a storm can come up and an insect can fly to Hawaii, and then it's completely isolated in Hawaii. And it's so isolated that no other relatives will migrate there, and it will become a genetically distinct population, and soon it would be called a new phylogenetic lineage or a new species. So that's an interesting explanation. The reason people have been skeptical of it is it seems so improbable that this would really be an important process, because it's such a rare thing for these long-distance dispersal events to happen. However, using these models that I've built, I can do model testing on that model versus other models, and actually I keep getting a lot of support for these rare founder events to be really important in biogeography. So that's kind of the main conclusion that I'm working on right now, and putting that into models where it hasn't been into the statistical models that we use to infer history is one of my main projects.
For more information about postdoctoral fellowships at the National Institute for Mathematical and Biological Synthesis, visit our website at www.nimbus.org.